Hi everyone. So today let's begin with discussing about the blood supply of the internal capsule. So in the total there are 6 arteries which supply the internal capsule. First of all you should know the name of arteries. The first one is the middle cerebral artery or MCA. Middle cerebral artery, then anterior cerebral artery ACA. Third artery supplying the internal capsule is the posterior communicating artery. Then you have anterior choroidal artery. Then you have the posterior cerebral artery. And lastly, you have the internal carotid artery. Okay, so these are the 6 arteries which supply the internal capsule. Now the question comes that which part of the internal capsule is supplied by which of the artery. So to understand this thing, I'll be explaining you this with the help of a simple diagram. On the other half or on the other side of the board, you can see that I have drawn this diagram. Okay, this is just simply to memorize that which part of the internal capsule is supplied by which artery. I have drawn a table over here and I have divided it into 3 columns. The first one is for the anterior limb. AL stands for the anterior limb. Second column stands for the genu. The third for the posterior limb. Then I have drawn a separate box for the retrolentiform part of the internal capsule. And then a separate box for the sublentiform part. Okay. Now, these symbols which I have drawn over here. First of all, I would like to tell you that these symbols correspond to which of the arteries. Now, as you can see that these oblique lines correspond to the middle cerebral artery. The horizontal lines correspond to the anterior cerebral artery. The dots will correspond to the posterior communicating artery. The cross symbol corresponds to the anterior choroidal artery. Triangles correspond to the posterior cerebral artery. And lastly, the wavy pattern or the waves correspond to the internal carotid artery. Okay. Now, understand this. Now see, this is the anterior limb. Now, anterior limb is supplied by 2 arteries. The one is the middle cerebral artery drawn with oblique lines. Okay. And the other is the anterior cerebral artery. So, the anterior limb will be supplied by the middle cerebral artery and the anterior cerebral artery. Okay. Then you have genu. Genu will also be supplied by the middle cerebral artery and the anterior cerebral artery. In addition to this, genu is also supplied by the posterior communicating artery, okay, and by the internal carotid artery, right? Coming to the posterior limb. The posterior limb is supplied by the middle cerebral artery and the anterior choroidal artery, okay? So till here, one thing to be remembered is that the first 3 parts of the internal capsule, that is the anterior limb, genu and the posterior limb, all of these 3 are supplied by the middle cerebral artery. Okay. Then the anterior limb and the genu is supplied by the anterior cerebral artery. Okay. In addition to that, genu is supplied by 2 more arteries. The one is the posterior communicating artery and the other is the ICA, that is the internal carotid artery. The posterior limb. Posterior limb, in addition to the middle cerebral artery, it is also supplied by the anterior choroidal artery. Okay. Now, talking about the retrolentiform part. Retrolentiform part will be supplied by only 1 artery and that is the posterior cerebral artery. Okay. As you can see that in this box, I have drawn only triangles. So, this indicates that the retrolentiform part is only and only supplied by the posterior cerebral artery, right? Now, heading forwards to the sublentiform part. The sublentiform part is supplied by 3 arteries. anterior choroidal artery, which is indicated by cross, the posterior cerebellar artery indicated by triangles, and lastly the internal carotid artery indicated by a wavy pattern. Okay, right? So once again I am telling you in a short and in brief, anterior limb, genuposterior limb, all three will be supplied by the middle cerebral artery. Okay, anterior limb and genu will be supplied by the anterior cerebral artery. Okay, in addition to this, the genu will be supplied by the posterior communicating artery indicated by dots and the internal carotid artery indicated by a wavy pattern. Talking about the posterior limb, it is supplied by the middle cerebral artery and the anterior choroidal artery, which is indicated by cross. One thing to be remembered over here is that the middle cerebral artery supplying the posterior limb is referred to as the artery of the cerebral hemorrhage or the Charcot's artery of cerebral hemorrhage. The reason being is that this artery, the middle cerebral artery supplying the posterior limb, often gets ruptured. It is liable to rupture, and thus it has been termed as the Charcot's artery of cerebral hemorrhage. This thing is very important and you should keep in your mind. Next, the retrolentiform part will be supplied by only one artery, that is the posterior cerebral artery. Then the sublentiform part will be supplied by the anterior choroidal artery indicated by cross, the posterior cerebral artery indicated by triangles, and lastly the internal carotid artery indicated by the wavy pattern. Now I'll tell you how to draw the diagram for the blood supply of the internal capsule. Okay, so now I'll be telling you that how we'll be drawing the diagram of the blood supply of the internal capsule. First of all, you should know that the arteries which I have described you, which supply the internal capsule, are the branches of which artery? Now see, these two are the vertebral arteries, and the two vertebral arteries unite to form the basilar artery. Here BA stands for the basilar artery. Now, the posterior cerebral artery, PCA, is the branch of the basilar artery. Okay? Then, this artery which you can see between the internal carotid artery and the posterior cerebral artery is the posterior communicating artery. Okay, this is the ICA, the internal carotid artery. Okay, now internal carotid artery has three branches: anterior cerebral artery, middle cerebral artery, and this is the anterior choroidal artery. Okay, this I have just drawn one side. Exactly the same thing will be present on the other half also. Okay, presently you should know one thing, that the posterior cerebral artery is the branch of the basilar artery. The basilar artery has been formed by the union of the two cerebral of the two vertebral arteries. Once again, the posterior cerebral artery is the branch of the basilar artery, and the basilar artery has been formed by the two vertebral arteries. Between the internal carotid artery and the posterior cerebral artery, this artery which you can see, this is the posterior communicating artery. Anterior cerebral artery, middle cerebral artery, and the anterior choroidal artery are the branches of the internal carotid artery. Okay, so fine. Now this is the diagram, okay, of the internal capsule. As you know that this entire is the lentiform nucleus, this is the head of caudate nucleus, this is thalamus. Now on the inferior surface of the thalamus you have geniculate bodies. The one which is on the lateral side is the lateral geniculate body, and this one is the medial geniculate body. Okay, coming to the parts of the internal capsule, you have anterior limb, genu, posterior limb, retrolentiform part, and this part which I have drawn, this is the sublentiform part. Okay, now one thing which you should know is that when we discussed about the fibers, I told you that the retrolentiform part has the it consists of the posterior thalamic radiations. Okay, these posterior thalamic radiations are also called as the optic radiations. Okay, while the sublentiform part consists of inferior thalamic radiations, which are called as the auditory radiations. basically what happens is that the signals from the medial geniculate body will travel to the sublentiform part in the form of auditory radiation so as to reach the primary auditory cortex for hearing. Okay. Now, let's draw the diagram. Now, see, anterior limb, you know that there are two arteries which supply the anterior limb. The middle cerebral artery and the anterior cerebral artery. So, what you will do is that you will take out one branch from the middle cerebral artery, okay, and you will supply it over here, okay. Similarly, you will take out one branch from the anterior cerebral artery and you will supply it over here. Now, from the diagram, it is well understood that the anterior limb is supplied by the anterior cerebral artery and the middle cerebral artery, okay. Heading forwards towards the genu. Genu is also supplied by the anterior cerebral and the middle cerebral arteries. So, for anterior cerebral artery we have drawn and for the middle cerebral artery. In addition, you have the posterior communicating artery. Here lies the posterior communicating artery. And then you have the internal carotid artery. And here is the internal carotid artery. Now see, you can very well see that the genu is supplied by anterior cerebral artery, the middle cerebral artery, the posterior communicating artery and the internal carotid artery. Okay. Now, talking about posterior limb, it is supplied by the middle cerebral artery. So, yes, the middle cerebral artery and you have the anterior carotid artery. And this artery, this is the anterior carotid artery, okay? And here you go. Thus, it's very clear from the diagram that posterior limb is supplied by the anterior carotid and the middle cerebral arteries. The retrolentiform part is supplied by only the posterior cerebral artery. And the posterior cerebral artery has been indicated by triangles and here you have the posterior cerebral artery. So, you will draw it like this. Right? Now, sublentiform part. The sublentiform part is supplied by the anterior choroidal artery. Here lies the anterior choroidal artery. So, one branch from the anterior choroidal artery supplying the sublentiform part. Then, you have the posterior cerebral artery. Here lies the posterior cerebral artery. One branch from posterior cerebral artery and supplying the sublentiform part. And lastly, the internal carotid artery. This is the internal carotid artery. Okay. So, now one branch from the internal carotid artery and it will supply the sublentiform part. Okay. So, in this way, you will draw the diagram for the blood supply of the internal capsule. Okay. What you have to do is first you will draw the basic diagram of the internal capsule and then you will draw this diagram of the arteries. Okay. The basilar artery is formed by the two vertebral arteries. Posterior cerebral artery is the branch of the basilar artery. Then you have the posterior communicating artery connecting the internal carotid artery and the posterior cerebral artery. Anterior cerebral artery, middle cerebral artery and the anterior choroidal artery are the branches of the internal carotid artery. Then you will just remember this figure and on the basis of this figure you will just draw this diagram. You will just take out the branches from each of the artery and you will supply the following parts of the internal capsule. Okay. So thus anterior limb is being supplied by anterior cerebral and the middle cerebral arteries. Genu by the anterior cerebral, middle cerebral. Posterior communicating, see the posterior communicating and lastly the internal carotid artery. Posterior limb supplied by the middle cerebral artery and the anterior choroidal artery, see. Okay, see this one. Anterior choroidal artery and the middle cerebral artery. Retrolentiform part is being supplied only by the posterior cerebral artery. So, I have taken out a branch from the posterior cerebral artery supplying the retrolentiform part. Sublentiform part is supplied by the internal carotid artery, okay, see, the internal carotid artery, the posterior cerebral artery and lastly the anterior choroidal artery, right? So this was all about the blood supply of the internal capsule. I hope that you understood it well, and now you know how to draw it up, okay? And just remember two arteries which are important. One is the recurrent artery of Hubner, which is actually the anterior cerebral artery, and another, which is the middle cerebral artery, supplying the posterior limb, often liable to rupture, is the Charcot's artery of cerebral hemorrhage, right? So this was all about the blood supply of the internal capsule. And if the coming talking something short about the clinical or the plight of the internal capsule, if there is damage to the internal capsule, so it would result into the contralateral hemiplegia, means the opposite half of the body will become paralyzed, okay? And the lesions to the internal capsule may be due to the hemorrhage, and the most common reason for the hemorrhage is the rupture of the Charcot's artery of cerebral hemorrhage. So this was all about the internal capsule. I hope you understood the concept well, and if you like my video, so do press on the like button. And if you have not subscribed to my channel till yet, so please do subscribe to my channel as well. And yes, don't forget to press on the bell icon so that you do not miss on to the latest updates and notifications of my channel. Thank you.